My name is Matthew Linebarger, and I'm here to talk to you about the Tower Technician Program here at TEEX, A Career Path to Adventure. Tower technicians are in demand. In today's world, telecommunications industry is a rapidly growing industry. As of now, in the next 10 years, the tower technician industry needs to fill 10,000 jobs. The TEEX Tower Technician Course, it is a 120-hour comprehensive course that combines traditional classroom training and hands-on training scenarios. All you need is a climbing boots, and we supply the rest. Topics and training covered. We go over the regulations and standards, the introduction to the wireless technology, work hazards, OSHA 10-hour, first aid CPR, and everything else required for you to perform the tower technician job. What you need to apply. Be a high school graduate or have a GED, be at least 18 years of age, have a valid driver's license, be in good physical health, and have a strong work ethic. What's in it for you? As of now, the base starting pay is usually 18 to 20 an hour. You do have a vast potential for travel around the U.S., so if adventure is your goal, this is where you should come. A certified tower technician is a rapidly growing industry. As a matter of fact, during the COVID pandemic, this is one of the few industries who was never shut down during lockdown procedures. Successful graduates are eligible for the Tower Apprentice Program, supported by industry hiring partners.
All right, ready? Good? All right, boys, how we feeling?
Amazing.
Good. Feel pretty good?
Yeah.
You could do it, right?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Would you do it for work?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Feel like you could do this in the industry for real?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
See how far you came from Monday to now, right?
Sure.
Monday, you guys were like, what is this harness? But now look at you.
Nice.
You safely scaled a tower up to 120 feet. And if you're asking me, dude, you look pretty comfortable. You trust your gear?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right on, man. It's a big deal. You guys did what a lot of people just refuse. They just go, nope, not doing it, can't do it.
Yeah.
Before they even try, they say they can't do it. But you guys did it. Take a gander. It's the office. It's great views every single time.
Good morning, my name is Alex Metzger. I'm one of the tower technician instructors here at TEEX. Today I'm gonna do a little demonstration on ascending a monopole section and safely descending on the ropes. You get to watch me manipulate my gear and, you know, safe practices across the board. Thank you. I'm ready to go. So, right now, I'm set up for basically ascending and descending ropes. It's not a flashy setup or anything like that. Kind of bare bones, kind of minimalist, but not at the same time. Could do a lot with this simple setup, but for the most part, this is kind of your basic setup, almost like industry standard, right? Got all your typical moving parts. This is a Skylotech Lori. It's my work position. It's my preferred work position. I see a lot of guys use things like the Grion, the Gri-Gri, and some of the older school stuff. This is a little more complicated, a couple more moving parts. Z359.4. If you know about ANSI, this is rescue rated. I can put two people on this. This is a rig. This is not an ID. So this is the expert use only configuration. There's no safety device here. My rope grab, rope safety device, my ASAP. Got a gate on it. I can trap rope in this, ascend, descend safely. But this setup isn't anything hardcore, high speed, whatever you want to call it. This is pretty bare bones. So what I'm going to do is ascend the monopole safely, hop on the ropes, and come on down. So cable climb, this is one version of many devices in the industry. Pretty simple configuration there, pretty simple application. It goes one way. So, a big part of climbing is problem solving. You're going to do a lot of troubleshooting. You're going to be in a lot of situations where you've got to think about your next move and how to do it safely. One of the biggest problems with monopoles in the industry is they'll just be cluttered. They'll be full of gear. There'll be antenna lines and equipment all over them. And a lot of the time, you'll have stuff right where you need to climb, on the exact place where you're following the rules, doing everything correctly, you're gonna have stuff in your way on a monopole. So it's frustrating, it's aggravating, but it can always be done safely. It can always be done in a way that, you know, you're not putting yourself or your other climbers at danger. So I'm on the top of the monopole here. I'm at the top of the crow's nest, and I've got a couple of ropes set up so that instead of going down the climbing face, which you can see is missing pegs, and we've mocked it up in a way to have a realistic experience on a monopole section, but another way to come down a tower is to descend on ropes, safely on ropes. But we've got a red rope and a blue rope. The red rope's gonna be my safety. The blue rope's gonna be my main rope. I've got my rig, my descent device, and my duck in place. What I'm gonna do here is get on the ropes. So, as you can see, I'm connected to the tower by only the ropes. That's it, hands free. Safety device, my main descent device. I'm 100% safe. Cool? So, how do I get down safely? Well, nothing changes. My safety device stays connected to the rope. My descent device is configured correctly. I can start coming down nice and easy.
So I'm still connected safely. My safety devices are still in place. My descent device still configured correctly. Everything's safe, good to go. Part of this is trusting my gear, right? Can't do stuff like this if I don't trust my gear. You know what I mean? The gear's rated for it. All the equipment can do this kind of stuff. Would you ever work like this? No, but it's just proof that, you know, what I'm doing is completely legal, completely safe. Earlier, you probably saw me put this on. Totally forgot I had it. This is another safety device, another way to connect to the rope. I ended up using a more simple version, but here, the ASAP, still have it on me. Extra gear, extra safe, you know? Good. Thank you so much for watching. I hope some of you got something out of that. I hope some of you who have interest, you know, take the initiative to ask questions and hit us up and get into the details with us. The requirements are pretty simple. You gotta be 18 years old, finish high school with a diploma or have a GED, something equivalent, and show up on time, be ready.
Thank you so much for your time during our tower technician presentation and demonstration. If you'd like more information about the Tower Technician Program, please feel free to contact me at matthew.weinbarger@teeks.tamu.edu.